Hello, Jesse Good here. Today I'll be reviewing all 17 minifigures from LEGO Minifigure Series 18, which is releasing in stores right now on April 1st, I think officially worldwide, and it retails for $4 a pack. Let's get into the minifigures. So here is the Elephant Girl, and I like the mouse molding the best probably because that is a new design with lots of great printing. I mean, you even got like a little small pink nose at the front. It's dual molded with a hard plastic base and then a kind of rubberish tail. And her mask is actually dual molded as well, where the tusks are not kind of painted, but rather just dual molding. It's interesting how that works out. You can see underneath where half of the inside is kind of this white. Now, her face print underneath is pretty funny. I like the singing face, or whatever you want to say it, screaming face. Then on the back, she does just have kind of a normal face print right there, which looks pretty good with the little mask on. The ballerina tutu is not new in that color, but it's still pretty cool to get. And also the base in each of the minifigures in this series is an exclusive orange, so that's kind of cool. So here's the red brick suit guy, and this design for the brick suit is freaking awesome. I mean, you could fit whatever you want on those six studs at the front, and I can see a lot of people being creative with that. I just stuck on the Elephant Girl. But his accessory, in my opinion, is a little bit lame. I wish he had something more than just a 1x1 in blue. And the design of the hairpiece, though, is probably my favorite part besides that brick outfit, because getting that coloring for that hairpiece is extremely useful. Now, if you're curious how this brick suit works, it's actually the torso itself, and they kind of leave space at the top for the head. And you can see the head actually fits in there perfectly. And if you want to remove the torso from the legs, you can see that it's just molded in to have those little spots so that you could fit the leg piece in. So people are going to be really creative with this brick suit, and I can't wait to see that. As for the blue brick suit girl, she has the same molding with the torso, but in blue, and the same accessory, but in red. And I do like that hair piece in the coloring, which is Wild Style's hair. But the design of the face is very chipper. There's no back facial printing or anything like that. But hopefully one day they'll do like a green brick suit and a purple brick suit, but not as minifigure spots, but rather maybe like little promotional poly bags or whatever you want to call it. So here is the Party Clown, and I would have been more hyped if we didn't get like 15 other CMF clowns, but the design of these little balloon animals is a really nice new molding where it actually gets held at the middle section of the body, so I think that's kind of clever. And it's sort of a hard plastic, but also this nice translucent design. And you do get one of them in a translucent green and one of them in this translucent pink. But the design of the torso is not bad as well as the legs, which have a little bit of printing to them, even down to the hips right there, which get kind of covered by this little, I guess, leg felt design. It's the same one that they use in the Lego Batman movie for some iterations of the Joker. Kind of sad to see that there's no back torso printing though, but this little hat piece, while it isn't a new molding, has some nice printing with the side right there and then the little kind of a flower up top. He also has the nice bow tie piece in this red coloring and kind of a silly looking face. Here's Firework Man, and I mean, have you ever seen somebody dress up as a firework in real life? I know I haven't. His firework design looks a lot like the big one from Toy Story, which was in Lego form before, funny enough. If you take off this interesting molding, I mean, it's a huge mold right here. You can see that his front torso has no printing. They literally just skimped out on that. And then he does have some printing on his legs, at least. My favorite part of the minifigure is the little face print. But it's just like, we don't even have any Lego fireworks like this besides the big one from Toy Story. And it just seems like such a weird costume. It's definitely one of my least favorites of the series. So here is the Birthday Girl. And she has a really interesting new hairpiece. You guys know I love my new hairpieces. And this one is another pigtail design. And her hairpiece actually has a little hole at the top, which I wish it didn't have that because that could be a little bit distracting. But I mean, if you look at her from the front, you can't really see it. You can see it just a bit, but I guess the ridges kind of cover that up. Either way, the design of her balloon piece is interesting because I thought this would be something where it's two pieces and it's actually just one whole molding. You cannot take this top part apart, even though it does have this interesting little slot at the top. I guess that's just how it was made. But it does have a nice kind of design where it kind of wraps at the bottom so that she could hold it straight up, which is something that a lot of the balloon pieces were missing from before. Other than that, though, she does have this new kind of molding for the present as well, where we have this box piece that has these little parts at the corner so that a piece like the 2x2 that kind of wraps it up can fit in place. What I don't like, though, is that her two accessories inside here are prints that have already existed before. They didn't have any new prints here. And we have that cookie print, which is very common to get. And the donut piece from the Lego Simpsons series, which they just reprinted there. Like, come on, you couldn't give it like a white frosting or something like that. In my opinion, that's just a bit lazy. But either way, that is it for this birthday party girl. So here is the dragon suit guy, and this is actually a tribute to the Lego Fantasy Era Castle dragon with the same colors and a similar design. Now we do have a new molding for the headpiece and the tail, or sort of the mask piece, which you can take off. You can see his face print, which looks pretty angry. It is good to get more screaming faces, and also his face print on the back is a more happy, chipper face. That's kind of funny as a contrast. I do like the printing on the side of his arms, though I wish they sort of had more printing maybe on the side of his legs, but other than that, it is a very good design overall. So the next minifigure is a classic policeman, and for a series that celebrates 40 years, this is a great little tribute because this was one of the first LEGO minifigures. Now, nothing is really new with his printing, but it is a reprint of a very old figure. You even have the classic smiley face and everything like that. However, the only new printing is this 1x2, which is great. And it has set number 600, which was where this policeman came in. So that's a nice little tribute, and I really appreciate that design. And that is on a 1x2 yellow plate. So here is the spider suit guy. And man, this is not one of my favorites of the series. We already have Spider-Man. We don't really need another spider outfit person. This one has this strange kind of neck attachment, which is a very rubber spider kind of backpack, or whatever you want to look at it. And then we do have an accessory, which is literally just the older style spider, which doesn't really make sense because this outfit looks closer to the newer style spider from, like, I think last year. So I don't know why they reprinted that there in black. And then we have this design with a newer mask piece and also a nice hoodie. I think the hoodie is probably my favorite part of the figure. You have a serious face right there, as well as a more nervous face, which I guess is a kind of cool design. I'm just happy that they at least continue the hoodie design at the back. And if you're curious how that little spider backpack looks like, it's very hollow with a lot of open space on the backside. So here is the birthday cake guy, and this is a very interesting design. The cake piece is a totally new molding, and I kind of appreciate how it has those minifigure designs on it. It looks pretty fun. And you kind of slip the minifigure inside there. You can see that the bottom has two receiving studs, and then inside it has two regular studs. And like I said, you just put the minifigure inside there. However, if you remove the minifigure from the cake, you can see that he does have some new printing on his legs. I just wish that the frosting wasn't stained on his torso, because it's a really nice torso design that now cannot be used because it has this frosting piece on it. His face looks similar to Benny's, and it's one-sided. And the other very weird part is that he does have the original male hairpiece for Lego, except now it's a sort of a new molding where you can see that the material on it is kind of like a harder material, rougher material, which makes these kind of waves at the front more defined. And then it has a hole at the top, which is kind of a strange twist on things. So you have the hole so that you could fit this little party hat. The party hat itself has never come in that pearl gold color before, so that's kind of cool. So just overall, very strange minifigure. Here's Cactus Suit Girl, and I don't think there's been any Lego cactuses that look like this, which is quite annoying. They made this very elaborate molding for this part that goes over the torso and the headpiece and even a little bit of the legs. And then they even made new molding for these two arms right here where she can't hold anything. However, what I like the best is actually the printing on the torso and the face print. In this series, we got a lot of face prints that are more expressive than ever, and this one looks very cool with the uncomfortable look. It's just the face print that we haven't gotten in LEGO before, but they also give you just a regular face right there, which is pretty neat as well. Here is the cat suit person, which the design of this looks like a LEGO Chima design with that newly molded kind of mask piece. And we do have a reprint of the tail piece in a very useful black coloring and some dual molded arms, which has some nice printing at the top. And her accessory is just this little fish. I like the face print underneath. It's pretty detailed, but that is it for the cat suit girl. Here is the race car driver, which is actually a nice reference to the Lego Racers video game with the Rocket Racer logo on there. This is actually one of my favorites of this series, funny enough, where there's just a lot of cool detailing on here. You get this miniature car mold, which even has this little engine at the back. That could easily be removed because it connects at the hips alone, which is quite interesting. And it's a full working car because you can see it even has some wheels on it, which is pretty cool as well. But once you remove that, you have a really nice looking minifigure with some even side arm printing and side leg printing, which you can see it says Cross Axle and Grand Prix instead of Grand Prix. Ha 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 ha. Clutch Drive at the back. And the face print underneath is pretty neat as well, with a little bit of facial hair going on there, but no back facial printing. Here is the flower suit girl, and there's not many Lego flowers that look like this, unless you're counting brick-built ones, which is a little bit annoying, but the design of this is interesting with this pot that actually attaches at the hips, and she does have a double-sided face, which you can see. She looks kind of worried there, again, with those very expressive faces that I really like throughout this series. And then she looks a little bit more happy on the side right there. And with the pot removed, you can see a better look at her torso. And if you want to see how that pot works, it literally just has these two holes for the hip part. So you just put the legs under there, then put the torso over. So here is the cowboy horse guy, whatever you want to call it. And the design of this is pretty interesting. You can see that it illustrates this horse kind of going through him. Thankfully, it looks like a Lego horse, unlike a lot of the suits in here where it doesn't really look like their Lego counterparts. There's little details I really like you can see the little hooves are printed on there, and even his legs have a little bit of hoof printing on them as well. His arms are kind of this nice bright orangish yellow, I think it is, which doesn't really go on arms too much, and he even has like the unicorn tail. Once you remove that rubber horsey, you can see a better look at his torso. And one thing I have to note is that in my pack opening, I said that was a new mold for the hat. It's actually not a new mold, but a new coloring for an old mold that was used in the Lego Movie line like once. So it is a very hard to find mold that they brought back. Then you have the party boy, who is pretty similar to the party girl, with a new coloring for the dual molded short legs, a new coloring for that balloon piece that was just like the party girl's, but a new hair piece as well, which I really like, with this kind of spiked up design. Hope to get that in different colors. And the torso is neat as well, where it kind of has a suit with little minifigure heads on it. His accessory is freaking awesome, where it's a 1x1 with the original Lego minifigure series 1 print on it. So that's neat that they included that reference. Then you also have another present, which has that new design as well, with little stripes all around the box. And then that's a 2x2 at the top. And inside, they actually give you another one of this series 1 pack. And I guess he had to pay a lot on eBay, because these sealed go for so much money. And unfortunately, we have to leave off with what might be the worst minifigure of the series. And that's the unicorn guy. I mean, come on, this is actually pretty lazy. The gender swaps are like the laziest collectible minifigure thing they could do. And this is literally a gender swap of the series 13 unicorn girl, which was already a little bit unnecessary. I don't know. And this one has the same piece with the tail right there that was used with the cowboy. The same molding as a unicorn girl, and you even have a horn up top here, which once you remove the face prints, you can see that he's winking, but there's no alternate face or anything like that. And he does have this interesting little torso print and shield print, which are probably my favorite parts of the minifigure, but that's not saying a lot. So surprisingly, I actually have the box a little bit early on in the run, so I get to cover it in this review. And the box for this is basically like the others, except now it has this little stripe that says 40 years, and it shows the policeman on there. And on the back, it just says 17 to collect, 40 years, 40 years, 40 years, and all the other minifigures right there. So that's it for the box of this set. The packaging has a very party-esque design to it, and in the corner where it usually says a series, it says 40 years, and they moved the series 18 to the bottom. You can see the back has some detailing to it as well. And the instructions don't have too much going on. You can see the checklist squeezes in the 17th minifigure. And then on the back, you can see that it has the Lego Life ad that they usually have at the end of instructions nowadays, and how to build some of the minifigures. So I guess me and Lego have different views of the Lego minifigure series, and a lot of you guys agree with Lego's views that these are supposed to be collectible, wacky, strange figures. Me personally, I look for them as more usable parts, you know, new designs that won't appear in sets. So we kind of clash there, and this is a series that is definitely more on the collectible side, because you won't find much use out of this little cactus person. It's more of just, look at this wacky minifigure, and that is okay. We're all entitled to our own opinion. But for something that celebrates 40 years of the LEGO minifigure, I just wish there was more tributes to the LEGO minifigure. You get some of them, like the dragon design, the rocket racer reappearance, the brick people, and even little references to past sets like the policeman and the little series 1 packet, but I just wish in general the whole thing was a tribute. So that's it for now. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and tell me what you guys think of Series 18. Am I completely wrong? Let me know in the comments. I'll see you guys later. Peace out.